Trichoepitheliomas are benign adnexal skin tumours showing hair follicle differentiation. They may be single or multiple lesions, and they present as skin-coloured firm papules. Solitary trichoepitheliomas are more frequent than multiple trichoepitheliomas. They present as skin-coloured nodules less than 2 cm across, and tend to affect children and young adults. And the sites involved are usually the head and neck, and occasionally elsewhere on hair-bearing skin. Multiple trichoepitheliomas are familial with an autosomal dominant inheritance. The Brooke-Spiegler syndrome is a condition where there is a predisposition to skin adnexal tumours, including trichoepithelioma, cylindromas and spiroadenomas. Multiple trichoepitheliomas occur more frequently in females than males, and as with the single ones, they present as skin-coloured papules, and they tend to affect the nasolabial folds, upper lip, forehead and nose, and their size may vary from around 2 to 8 millimetres in diameter. Trichoepitheliomas are important to recognise, as the main differential diagnosis is basal cell carcinoma. Trichoepitheliomas are, of course, benign. Histologically, they are well circumscribed. They contain horn cysts with a keratinized centre surrounded by basaloid cells. There may be areas of calcification and foreign body type granulomas as a reaction to liberated keratin, and islands and lace-like areas and solid groups of basaloid cells may be present. The stroma is often fibrotic. This is a low-power view of a typical trichoepithelioma with lobules of basaloid cells. As we zoom into this trichoepithelioma, you can see the islands and groups of basaloid cells, and in areas there's a sort of cribriform and slightly lacy pattern. And the other feature, as we pan down the slide, is this rather fibrotic stroma, so typical of a trichoepithelioma. And finally, here is another feature of trichoepitheliomas. This is a horn cyst, and the keratin has started to calcify, and adjacent to this there is liberated keratin that has calcified in the adjacent dermis with a foreign body granulomatous reaction to it.